Still confused as to whether the moon is a star or a planet? I can fix that. Hey guys, Amy here to talk space on DNews. There's been a lot of talk recently about dwarf planets versus regular planets, comets, asteroids, not to mention some questions about what exactly is a natural satellite. Well, let's break down what exactly is kicking around in our solar system. At the center is our sun, which is a star. A star is a luminous ball of gas, mostly hydrogen and helium, that is held together by its own gravity. Nuclear fusion in its core produces photons, the light that we see, as well as heat and trace amounts of other heavy elements. But not all stars are the same. Stars can be different colors depending on their temperature. Hotter stars looking slightly bluer, while cooler stars look slightly more red. And stars are typically different sizes, the cooler stars being smaller. As stars evolve and age, depending on their mass, they expand and eventually puff up as red giants and rip themselves to shreds. That's what happens to stars about the mass of our sun, and then they turn into a white dwarf, or if they are really massive, they explode as supernovas before turning into a neutron star or a black hole. Then there are brown dwarfs, which are sometimes called failed stars because they just aren't big enough to start the fusion reaction that makes a star bright. Brown dwarfs also have planet-like qualities, making them kind of a bridge between stars and planets. Orbiting all kinds of stars are the planets, but for a body to be classified as a planet, it has to meet three additional criteria as laid out by the International Astronomical Union. It has to be large enough to be round, it cannot be a satellite of another body, and it must have cleared its orbit of all nearby debris. This is basically putting a minimum size limit on planets, but as long as they're big enough, planets come in all different types and sizes. The Earth is a rocky terrestrial planet, as are Mercury, Venus, and Mars. The outer planets, Jupiter, Saturn, Uranus, and Neptune, are called gas giants, though those last two can sometimes be called ice giants as well. But when we talk about planets around other stars, we have slightly different descriptors. There are super-Earths, which aren't exactly what they sound like. These are planets more massive than the Earth, but still far less massive than Uranus or Neptune, which are 15 and 17 times as massive as the Earth, respectively. On the other end of the size spectrum are dwarf planets, planets that are too small to have cleared their orbital path of debris, like Ceres, the dwarf planet we've talked about before, which is in the asteroid belt. Pluto is a dwarf planet as well, though in recognition of everybody's favorite little body, the IAU recently designated all dwarf planets that orbit beyond Neptune as Plutoids. But regardless of size, type, or distance from its host star, any planet can have a moon. A moon is a natural satellite, a body that makes an orbit around a planet. Moons can have water like Europa, can have thick atmospheres like Titan, or be, for all intents and purposes, a dead world like our own moon. As long as it's orbiting a planet, it's a moon. Of course, there are other subcategories and intricacies in individual bodies, but those are sort of the basics. Does that clear things up? If you have any more questions on celestial bodies, let us know in the comments below, or you can ask me on Twitter as AST Vintage Space. And don't forget to subscribe for more DNews every day of the week.